excited about this. This is like a little cheesy for my taste.
Since we are approaching the end of 2017, we're going to listen to the mountain of comments and show you a selection of K-pop songs that came out this year.
Oh, no. Oh my god!
I actually contributed to those comments. I'm doing K-pop. When the YouTubers reacted to my K-pop, like, way in the beginning, and it just started from there, and I haven't stopped since then.
All these songs are hugely requested, and we can never satisfy everyone. It has been a while since we've put K-pop on this channel, so we're going to hope to satisfy some of the K-pop fans' selection of songs this year.
Cool, because you're satisfying me right now.
Excited. I don't listen to it. It's not something I like to listen to.
First up, we have a song by the most requested K-pop group that did not get covered on this show over the years,
Monsta
X.
Oh, yes!
Monsta X. Okay, let's watch this. I like it. They're going a cappella.
They're so cool looking.
They got a sticker smash, and that's by far a auditory hallucination.
I love the production they have for the music video, though.
Like, I really want to be in a boy band just because of this.
Why are three boys so cute? Oh my god.
It's jiggy.
They're music videos, I'm telling you. They're so good. I can't. I don't like that. You're not gonna fall asleep to this music, you know? It's very, like, hype up and style. I like it.
This group, I can just, like, bob my head to. Like, if I'm playing video games, I feel like this would get me in the zone.
The members of Monsta X were chosen through a survival show called No Mercy on South Korean music channel Mnet.
What? No Mercy? Sounds intense.
In 2017, they had their most successful year so far. American music charts. And like other big K-pop groups, they have their own variety show on TV called Monsta X.
Ooh!
What do you think about how you can have a favorite music group and also be able to not just have music and music videos, but even TV shows to see?
It makes you connect with them more. I really like that idea. That is also why there's more of an aspect of a stronger fan base. I love when I see shows like that for members of K-pop fans. You're literally learning about the member, you're learning about their family members, you feel connected with them.
Next, we have a music video from a group called Twice.
Wait.
Oh my gosh, I love that. Twice, like, I know, like, the dances and everything.
Who we have shown before on YouTube was the act episode, but it's also formed for a musical survival show, this one called 16.
Okay. What's up with all these K-pop bands coming from TV shows?
It narrows down all of the talents, and then they can pick out people who would be good matches for each other. It usually works.
Very pop.
Very different vibe than the last group. Very different vibe. See, this is so cute. This is pure. This is what I love about them. This is like a little cheesy for my taste. Not something that I would necessarily listen to.
They're so cute. Oh my god. They're so cute.
I love this. That was cool. I like that one. They're very creative with the music videos.
Twice apparently broke a YouTube record for a K-pop girl group with the most views in the shortest amount of time with that single, with more than 90 million views in only 27 days and just 20 hours.
Whew! You go, girl!
Even if you are seeing this video for the first time and haven't heard many K-pop girl bands before, what do you think it was about that song or video that sets it apart from the rest to have garnered this many views so quickly?
I mean, it was a really catchy song, like an uplifting, happy song.
It's so catchy, they're so cute. Their dances, they're really cute to do. And it's like, there's something you've never thought of before. And it's like, you want
to
do it.
So we have a few more videos to show you for today. The next one is the video for the single Clap by the band 17.
I'm digging his hair. These dudes dress so fresh, I swear to God. So many people in these groups.
Holy crap, why are there so many of them?
Lit. Like, there's a lot going on in this. This looks like so much fun. Like, I'm so jealous.
Everything is so colorful and, like, pretty. This is also really catchy.
Whoa. How many of them are there? Is there 17 people?
It's a nice song. It's just not something I listen to. And I like that they're all into it.
Yeah, I like this one the best so far. But they're fun. They're really fun. Like, they're like a friend squad.
So 17 is made up of 13 members.
Jeez.
They're multinational, Chinese, Korean, and Korean-American, which also is a trait of some K-pop groups.
Oh, absolutely.
They are one group that focuses sub-units within the band. One focuses on vocals, one on performance, one on hip-hop. One of them to perform as a unit without their
really sick.
Cool, it's like a mega group.
It's a live show. Incredible. What do you think about that?
I think that's kind of cool.
That's strategic and that's really smart. There's no way for them to like slip through a bump or anything. It's like it's all calculated. Voting in on their talents is genius. I never even thought of doing that. And now I get what they have 13 members.
Like multi-diversity and like multi-countries and like even different focuses on music. You can come up with so much more stuff.
So the next music video is from band Red Velvet.
Red Velvet. They're gonna be sweet, like cake.
I love them. They were cute when they came out and they grew to be more mature. And they matured in their music and it built up. And that's one of the really big girl groups that I know.
So much going on. So much fun.
This is different.
This almost looks like a commercial.
Their hairstyles are so cute.
Judging fruit?
I'm so confused.
God, I'm so frustrated by stuff. I'm like super cheesy, but I'm like bopping in my chair.
I like that one. That one is my favorite.
It's a song where it's like you want to go skipping in a field. Like all of this. I just want to skip in a field of flowers.
They're good songs, but this song I like to listen to. I'm not really into girl groups either, so I think that's kind of good too.
Red Velvet's branding is actually like a representation of their sound as a whole. That's somewhat unique from what we could research. People at home should let us know if there are any other similarities. The Red Velvet represents the catchy pop in their music, while the Velvet is representative of their slower R&B sound.
Okay. Yeah, I did notice that one didn't have like the bass drop like the other ones had.
And feminines are a thing across the world and also in K-pop. So if you are in Red Velvet's fandom, you are part of the Red Velvet.
Oh, okay.
That is a massive part of K-pop in a way unparalleled, possibly with anything in music today. We know this from the endless requests to cover K-pop, to endless people who wish we would leave their fandom alone. Kind of a double-edged sword. What is your opinion on the K-pop fandom at large?
The K-pop fandom is a wonderful place. It's full of so much diversity and so much, like, togetherness.
I've never seen fandoms this dedicated to, you know, the artists that they listen to, and I think that's one of the things that contributes to the, you know, wide success of K-pop artists.
When you find a group, it's kind of your thing, especially if, like, no one's told you about it, so you want to keep it your thing for as long as possible, but it's so good that you want to share it with everyone.
These days, you can't do a K-pop video without including BTS.
Of course!
Because no matter how many times you come, people will get upset if you don't show up. So we have a quote from this year's Grammy Music Awards with BTS and the US TV debut, and make history as the first K-pop group to ever be on the list.
That's wild. That's so sick.
That's just showing how K-pop is coming over to America.
Making their US TV debut! Make some noise!
Is it the chain smokers?
K-pop groups going forward, so yeah, big ups to BTS, like that's big time.
A different culture literally coming in and like everyone's loving it, that's super cool to see.
So we have now been covering K-pop for over half a decade on this channel. You could say that now, but for them, it has become much more mainstream. Do you think it would get so mainstream that it would be considered a niche at all? Just like a little subgenre of music here in America?
No, because of the language barrier.
I really hope that it stays like a niche, because I'll probably stop liking it if it like gets really big. If you even look on your phone, like it's already a genre, like on your Apple Music. So why wouldn't it become a major genre?
I don't think there's like this cultural barrier anyone that we used to have like years ago where it was kind of like, we don't want any different type of music. We have our American.